Now back to Outdoors with Larry Ray on ESPN 790 AM. Brought to you proudly by the Tennessee Wildlife Resource Agency, Gaston's White River Resort, Sportsman's Warehouse, and Barton Power Sports.
Hey, good Saturday morning. Welcome back to Outdoors with Larry Ray on ESPN 790. Coming up in August, we'll be celebrating another anniversary. I don't know if it's 15 or 16. I get so carried away. I think it's 16. It may be 15. I can't remember, but it's a long time. And this guy,
I think it's year 15 and going into the 16th.
That's year. What it is. It's year 15 going into the 16th year. And Frank Barton, third Saturday of the month, and Frank just started saying, "Well, I think I've been on with some of these guests before. I just work it out, Frank."
I'm confident I have.
I think you have been too.
Always enjoy it. I get the good ones.
You get the good ones. That's right. And this is one of our favorite guests right now. And I told him I've got my buck knife right in front of me here in my breakup infinity that I carry all the time. And you know I'm talking about C.J. Buck of the famous the Buck Knives. Good morning, C.J.
Good morning, Larry.
Hey, buddy. Thanks for being on with us again. And thanks for your support over these 15, 16 years for Outdoors with Larry Ray as we roll along here in Memphis, Tennessee. And wanted to talk to C.J. You know, we'll talk a little products too, but also an honor that the Buck family received recently down in Atlanta at the 2016 Blade Show when the Blade Magazine Cutlery Hall of Fame has added another Buck, and that's CJ.
Congratulations. Yeah, no, it is quite an honor. The Cutlery Hall of Fame, it's been up and running since 1982.
Yes.
There's 52 folks already inducted, people that have had an impact, a design impact or an industry impact, and both my grandfather and my father are prior
wow.
inductees
yeah.
into the Cutlery Hall of Fame.
And that's pretty cool. First comes the man who started it all, your grandfather, Al.
Yep.
And then your dad, Charles, and,
yep.
and now you. And I want to talk a little bit on today's show because Buck Knives are so well known. And CJ, you guys have wonderful products and things along that line. But what was it like growing up in the Buck family?
Oh, great question. You know, because I thought about it, my youth was so different than my father and grandfather because
mm-hmm.
Buck Knives was nothing. It was not part of their lives. Growing up,
mm-hmm.
So my grandfather was 35 years old before his dad moved in with him, and together they made custom knives together. So up until 35 years old, he'd never made a knife in his life. He was a bus driver.
Really?
He drove a bus. That was his job. He had tenure. He had a good route downtown San Diego. My grandfather was a bit of a character, so I just imagine him with these interactions of, you know, the same people getting on the bus every morning at the same stop, and I'm sure he had something funny to say to him. He was just a complete character. But, you know, for me growing up, the knife company was already there.
Uh-huh.
And so I really grew up hearing knife stories.
Knife stories.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, I grew up hearing about how this knife saved my life, this knife. Oh, I left it on the trunk of my car, drove off, went back and found it, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
I mean, just all these knife stories handed down from generations. Oh, your grandpa did this or your dad did that. So it's a neat legacy to be a part of. And my son, Josh, who's
yes.
30,
yeah.
uh-huh. is stepping right in, as well as my daughter, Sarah, both working in our company. So we are now a fifth generation
wow
family knife company.
Now I don't know how old you are. I'm 73. I'm proud of it. Okay.
55.
Oh, you're just a pup. Yeah, just a pup.
Pup,
just a pup. So did you know your grandfather? Was he part of your early life, or did he pass away before you had a chance to really know him?
No, I never met my great-grandfather.
Okay.
But, yeah, my grandfather was a huge part of my life. He was a wonderful man. He just had an integrity that went all the way to the bone, and that really is the basis of where our company came from. So it was his own integrity,
yeah,
and his faith in God,
uh-huh,
and he combined those two things to do the first lifetime warranty in our industry.
Lifetime.
Because he just believed in taking care of people.
Now, was Al the one that drove the bus?
Yes.
Wow.
Okay. Yeah.
I had no idea of that.
So imagine he's a 35-year-old living in San Diego with his wife and four kids. He's a bus driver, and his parents are living in Idaho.
Yeah.
And they contact him and say, our health, we can't do winters up here anymore. We've got to get to a more gentle climate.
Uh-huh.
We're coming to move in with you. And,
oh, wow.
And so I think, boy, if my great-grandparents had chosen another brother to go move in with, that family would be involved with Buck Knives, and we wouldn't.
And you wouldn't be. And again,
yeah, so I'm really happy that, you know, and I also think that my grandfather at any, like my great-granddad Hoyt,
uh-huh,
he came down in 1945. He passed away in 49. He only lived with my grandfather for 2 or 3 years, so that 2 or 3 year period was when he taught my granddad how to make knives.
Wow.
And my granddad kept it going after that. And I just think my granddad could have got up any one of those days and said, you know what, this knife thing is just loud, noisy, dirty. I just don't want to deal with it anymore. And it could have stopped at any time.
But it wasn't to be.
But it was not to be. Yeah, no, my granddad had a thought that of the possibilities. He hooked up with a couple people in his church choir.
Yes, I remember.
Who were involved in the defense industry, so they had great manufacturing depth.
Yeah.
Got us into took us off of that custom knife path and put us on a production path. And, I mean, introduced the 110 in 1964, and it's been crazy ever since.
1964. I mean, and we're talking to CJ Buck. He's the president, CEO, and chairman of Buck Knives, and recently inducted into the Blade Magazine Cutlery Hall of Fame. And wow, growing up in this family, you've passed it on to Josh. You passed it on to Sarah. Was it expected, CJ, that you were going to do this?
You know, it's funny. My mom has a funny story of me in the first grade. And it was bring your parent to school day. And so the parents are all sitting in the back, and the teacher's asking the kids to stand up and say what they're gonna be
uh-huh,
when they grow up.
Yeah.
And so kids were talking, you know, policeman, fireman, astronaut, whatever. And so my mom said, I got up, and in kind of a dejected way, I said, well, my grandpa runs a knife company, my dad runs a knife company, so I guess that's what I'm going to do, too.
Oh, my gosh.
And sat down, and she just laughed. And, and now, man, I couldn't imagine doing anything else.
And you've done this, Frank Barton,
I'm just laughing at what you say, a knife company, and yeah. I'm thinking the knife company.
Yeah, A and V, there's a lot of difference in this, CJ. You know
yes,
what
sir.
I mean? Because I don't know how many Buck Knives are out there. But and I don't know how many you make in a year. I don't have any idea. But
yeah, we make a couple million every year.
Couple of million every year.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
There's
so,
a lot of them out there.
But the pride is still there, isn't it? I mean, you know, I know there's people say I make them one at a time, but you said the stories are out there over these years. So to go in the Hall of Fame after your dad and after your grandfather. And I have to admit, folks, off the air, he said he wasn't able to go because he had to take care of his wife. Now, is this not a great Father's Day weekend guy right here? I mean, his wife, well, she'd had surgery and he stayed and take care of her. She had a bad wing. So,
yeah.
But I know your granddad laid the legacy. Your dad laid the legacy that came along. And now you're passing it on to Josh and Sarah. And what's the future here, CJ? I mean,
It's long and bright. It is. I think manufacturing is alive and well in the U.S. I think providing, you know, quality products to people that help them in their lives.
Mm-hmm.
It's so energizing. Again, couldn't see doing anything else.
And I know you guys for 2016. Is there anything out there that can be invented? You guys still working on these things?
Yeah, that was another funny story. But we I remember an industry meeting, and we were all sitting around, a bunch of us, and like this was back in the mid-'80s, thinking, yeah, man, about everything there is to be invented with knives has been invented. I don't know what we're all going to do now. And we were all just kind of laughing. And there's been so many innovations since then.
Yes.
Ergonomics, how the knife opens and closes, new materials. There's just always innovation that's coming in, introducing itself into the industry.
Well, I know you guys have been really a big help on our show here, and I appreciate our friendship. And can't tell you how many knives he's donated for worthy causes on Outdoors with Larry Ray over the years. God bless you, buddy, and just continued success in 2016. Hope you have a great Father's Day. You said you're going to get some ice cream. All right,
yes,
sir. Get a scoop for me, okay?
We are going to put a serious dent in the ice cream inventory.
That's all right. Thank you, CJ. Have a great day.
Thanks, Larry. Thank you, Frank. It's good to talk to both of you.
Okay, thank you. All right. That's pretty cool, you know. He said hello to you, too, Frank.
Mr. Buck.
Mr. Buck did. He's not Uncle Buck. I guess he's got a brother that's Uncle Buck to him. You know, I don't think that it's the right ones, but...
You know, when I was growing up in rural Illinois, like, I didn't know there were knives other than buck knives.
Well, that's
when
right.
When people talked about knives, it was,
and there are, I mean, we've
get a
had
buck some, knife. That's all they said.
Yeah, we've had, you know, some other ones on the show, of course, but the knife, as you said, not a knife. I like that.
The Knife Company.
Yeah. Do you have a buck knife?
Several.
Several. Okay. Several. Okay. Well, I just brought this one out of the, you know, because this is one of my cool things. It's got the real tree. The breakup, and I have that, and I don't want to lose it because it's in camo, but I've used it for many different things. And
I have one that you gave me.
I did, didn't I? That's right. I did give you that nice one.
That Mr. Buck signed.
Yes, I forgot about that.
I have it.
Yeah. Well, you know, so we're going to, pretty cool, though. Go to Buck Knives. Over 100 years of experience in craftsmanship. Just Google Buck Knives. I mean, what a deal for them, and to know that he's in the Hall of Fame and his daddy. That bus story I've never heard. So that was pretty cool that his granddad was driving buses. Never almost did it. All right, let's take a break. Come right back. Hey, we're going to talk to somebody really special on Outdoors with Larry Ray. She's been on us several times, but we can't wait to talk to her again. Be right back. See if we can hook up with the one and only Kim Rohde on Outdoors with Larry Ray on ESPN 790.
You can find out all about it on Outdoors with Larry.